Okay guys, Josiah here, and today I just wanted to go over the process of creating your own custom strategies in Thinkorswim. So right now I've got just a blank chart here with the E-mini S&P, and I've got a simple short strategy applied to the chart here, and this is the P&L curve here, the profit and loss. And so you can see here individual trades, it's shorted here and covered here, and so that was a profitable trade. Down here you can see the equity P&L grew from here to here. Then over here we had a losing trade, we shorted on the close of this bar, on the open of this bar, because I guess this was the entry here, and then covered up here, and so that was loss, and so the equity curve decreased there. And so then we had a winning trade, kind of a break-even losing trade there, and a winning trade, losing trade, and so forth. So this is how, you know, what you'd expect to see when you apply a strategy to a chart in Thinkorswim. So what I'm going to do is just go through the process of creating a simple strategy to just give viewers an idea of how to do it on their own and how to make their own strategies. So here's the strategy that I have applied right now. I'm going to delete that. Apply the changes, so that goes away. And then I'm going to go to strategies here. And this is the list of all the strategies that come built in and any other ones that you've added to your Thinkorswim installation. So I'm going to click new here. And by default, it's just going to have this basic line here, add an order. And it says buy. And I think this is it's telling it actually, no, don't buy. But so that's never going to get executed as it currently stands. Anyway, we'll just name this MA crossover. And what we'll do is we'll create a couple of inputs. Short MA length equals, we'll put that at 10, just something random here, and long MA length equals, I don't know, we'll say 50. And so what these inputs do, let me go ahead and accept this. So what those inputs do is they now appear here, short MA length 10, long MA length 50, so that you can just, you don't have to change the code in the future. You can just change the inputs to the strategy here and it will take effect on the chart. So that's what calling something an input does, is it adds it to that properties menu. This is the variable name and this is the value that you're assigning to it by default. And then a user can come back and change that input in the properties menu to whatever they want later. Let's see, what else will we need for this? Well, let's just go ahead and implement something really simple here to start out with. Define, def means define. We're going to define a buy condition. So we'll say, I want to buy if, I think this is the one we use here. So crossing direction, I'll put it above. And then okay, I'm just figuring this out as I go here, but so let me define my moving averages. So short MA is going to be a simple moving average of the closing prices, and by default they choose 9, but you can actually go into the code and specify here that you want the length to be the short MA length, and that will pull in whatever value we have stored in this and whatever value that the user later changes in that properties window over here. And so they can customize that, and it will change this the moving average on the fly. Then we'll define the long MA equals simple moving average length equals long MA length. Now, since I've never used that crossover, let me. We'll just do one simple thing here. If we'll just say we're going to buy whenever the short MA has been below the long MA as of yesterday, and today it's above the long MA. And so we'll say short MA from yesterday, one day ago, was less than long MA from one day ago. And short MA today is greater than long MA today. So we're just going to buy, basically, if the short MA crosses above the long MA as between yesterday and today. So then what we'll say here is add order, order type buy auto just takes care of it in the program itself, but you can say buy to open or buy to close specifically. But we'll say buy to open if the condition buy is set to true. So if these things are all true, then this will evaluate to true, and so this will say yes, we want to buy to open. Then we can specify here, over on the side here, what price we're going to buy at, the trade size, which I just like to leave blank and set in the global settings. You can change your colors, and we can just call this a specific name. We'll say crossover buy. And so I hit enter, and that applies the name. So that's what we should see. Now let's see if this actually, if I know what I'm doing here. And just for, so we know what's going on, we're going to go ahead and add those simple moving averages. So I'm going to add two simple moving averages. One is going to be the, I think we said the 10. And one is going to be the 50. Let me change the colors just so we don't get them confused here. So whenever the 10 MA crosses over the 50 MA, we should be issuing a buy signal. Why are we not issuing a buy signal? What am I not seeing here? We had some, oh, well, duh. The what's going on here is that we had one initial buy happen, and I have no exit conditions. So all it does is the first time that this actually is true, which it was true on this day right here, this day the 10 was above the 50, and this day it was below, so the condition evaluated to true, and so it bought on the open of the first bar after that condition was true. And so all this P&L is just the basically what the market has done since that entry condition. So we'll go back in here into the study or into the strategy, edit sources. And so now we need to add a condition for selling to close out the position. So, you know, this is probably going to be a terrible strategy, but we'll just say close the position, sell the position when the short MA is less than the long MA again. So once it goes back below the long MA, then we want to sell out. And so we'll say add order. So that's, we've just defined our exit condition here. And so now we're going to go ahead and add the order. Order type, sell to close. If sell evaluates to true, if those conditions are met. And the name we're just going to apply is crossover exit. So let's see what this does. It's probably going to be terrible, but so here are all the entries and exits. Actually, let's do one more thing here, which is to color these a little differently so you can see them better. So I'll just make my entries a gray color, wherever that is. There we go. Oops, and where'd we go here? Mark as gray. And these, the exits we want to be, we'll just make them green. And I don't really want the dark green, I'll just do the light green. I'm pretty particular about my colors. Okay, so let's try that. So now you can kind of differentiate a little bit better between the entries and the exits. So crossover buy, crossed over here, the condition was true. And crossover exit, the condition for exiting became true here. So actually this is not nearly as bad as I thought it was, but you can see it's, you know, definitely not necessarily the most efficient strategy out there. But anyway, so that that should give you an idea how this how strategies in Thinkorswim work. Essentially, to make your own strategy, you just go up here to Studies, or you can also go to the Studies menu here, if my computer will ever catch up here, Edit Studies, and then you can go to Strategies and click New, and, you know, once again, create whatever strategy you want here, or add any of these. And a good resource for actually learning this is to, you know, check out some of these existing strategies that Thinkorswim provides for you to see how they, you know, use different indicators like Bollinger Bands and so forth, Dongjin channels and so forth. So you can kind of learn how they work using the you know, resources that Thinkorswim has already provided for us, and but at least that will give you an idea of how to create a strategy from scratch. So I hope this helped. Let me know in the comments if you have any questions, and feel free to check out our site. I have several strategies available on the site at thinkorswim.net, which is where I publish all my work. So thanks a lot for watching, and we'll talk to you later.